about a $50 cab ride away from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the New York Jets. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. Going to get 10 and a quick first down.
And that's a run that will energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Second and 11. And his throw is incomplete. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, there in coverage.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw. It's caught, Jones. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big one there for the Jags. 18 yards, first down.
First down, Jacksonville.
They run the counter play. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
This won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, third and 1.
Well, big man with ball met bigger man on the other side of the line. A really nice play for the defense.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. 3 tight ends. Going to give this time to the tailback. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
Brings up fourth down.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And this crowd loves it as their guys hold on the opening drive. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. You can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
Tackled by the corner, C.J. Henderson. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and 6.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Now they try the right side here. And he'll get about 3 as he's brought down to the 28.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal. The Jaguars 7.
And he is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football. And for good reason.
This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover.
First down, Jaguars.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. He just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Now back to throw. And that's incomplete.
Intended for his running back. Incomplete.
Failure to connect on 2nd down. That leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. They'll set up a throw. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked up at the 12. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Jets
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And that last touchdown drive they had, very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge, because most of the time when we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times when you talk to offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they imposed their will on that last drive. Out to the left, flat and complete. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
A gain of a yard brings up third.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. The Jaguars going to go ahead. Use their first timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Taken in at the 22. A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And the Jaguars go on offense. First down and 10. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play call. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does, depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
Eluding the pressure right. They'll try and run it. And oh, he coughed it up. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And his guys are going to take over at the 44-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys have to touch the ball and carry it. They're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 35-yard line.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And finally down at the 9-yard line. And I think that's a pretty good illustration of why they try to get the football into his hands out of the backfield. That was something else. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was staying in the pocket. But just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Second and 9 now. Flush to his right. toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. The linebacker, Miles Jack, able to knock that one away.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And his kick is indeed good. And the lead moves to 10-0. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think the coach will be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that makes our score 17-0. Taking it about the 1. And they'll be backed up a bit to start as he's out of bounds at the 16.
At their own 16-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. The question, how do they do it?
It is the age-old question, isn't it? And to me, finding a way to make sure your playmakers touch the ball without it being too exotic. Meaning you don't have to go deep down the field. Maybe you hit them on those short passes on the perimeter. Make sure you just turn around and hand it to your best runner and get out of the way. Don't cause any extra stress on your offense.
No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
The Jaguars on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. And Jones has it over the middle. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. 3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Brings up 2nd down.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down. No gain at all on the play there, and that brings up four.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve, and that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he should be able to pin him back deep. And look at this, it's a fake. Oh, but he'll be stopped now well short of the first down marker, and it's a turnover on downs. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool him. And the Jets are going to get the football back. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 44. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Everson Griffin in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. They'll roll him out right. He finds Corey Davis. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. On play action, they'll throw. Buying time to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short.
That was a good effort there, trying to do it on his own. But as a defender, you're in a tough spot because you have coverage responsibilities behind you. And if you take off too quick to try and get him down, he might have locked it over your head.
So better to track with your man defensively than try to go up and make a stop on the quarterback.
Exactly right. What you're hoping is that your guys in the front seven can get him down.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Taking matters into his own hands, and he picks up 4 yards and a first down. They'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Jags grab it. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
Recovered by Jacksonville.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Ashton Davis. So we've hit halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the home team, the Jets, leading this one. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
Yeah. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And last time, the fumble, the turnover. Now they still have the lead, but I don't think coaches care. The turnovers will bother them no matter what the scoreboard says.
That's the relief, that you still have the lead. The coaches look at what if and what it should be. Turning the ball over when they've got a chance to score more points and increase the lead, that's what's going to affect them.
And they're also thinking to future weeks, maybe when the game's closer, right?
No doubt about it. You want to clean up everything. Let's just be honest about it. They want everything to be perfect at all times. They don't want to give up anything that's going to hurt their team.
And this one is incomplete. Corey Davis, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He finds his target, it's Crowder. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find them.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3-score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short. And it's fourth down. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. And they'll run it. This is James Robinson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, in on the stop.
The 47-yard line.
Back to throw now on second and 10. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
And the Jaguars first down.
They'll run on first down. It's Robinson. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the Jets, 25-yard line.
He'll drop to throw. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Back to throw here. Yeah, he's got it. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Jaguars get a score closer. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it up.
It's caught inside the 25. And all the way down inside the 25 before he gets out of bounds. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. He'll look to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and it'll bring up a second and 13. This one to his running back out of the backfield. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They're going to look to throw. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
It's a gain of 25 yards.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And a good burst there gets him 7 up to midfield.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to get this down close to a first at about the Jets' 41.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First down.
Now a handoff looking right. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit. And again, this time to the tailback. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Big things today, baby. Big things today, y'all.
A loss of 2 yards. And it's third down.
Come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. They'll go to the air here on third and 2. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Hitting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now they'll run it on the toss. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. So first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
When you run into slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there's no space available. An incompletion as a result.
A lot of tired bodies on that field. But this is a big play, third and goal. Into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. James Robinson, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are back within a score. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game.
Jets 17, Jaguars 14.
And Lambeau now after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
They'll look to throw here. Throw complete to Herndon. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down. A much better effort we're seeing from him under center this week versus last week when he threw 4 picks.
He has thrown to 1 in this game, but you're right. When you cut it down from 4 the previous week, and we always talk about adjustments. Well, he made some in practice, and he continues to work on it during the game. I'm sure he's getting plenty of reminders about how to stay in the moment, stay focused on the task.
And he's got him in the driver's seat here in the fourth quarter. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there, and now it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he winds up getting this all the way down to the Jags 24. And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive. Right back to him on first down. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Forced out to his left. But now he's going to use his legs. And he is out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. Here we go. Third and 1. Gut check time on both sides. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
Now they try the right side here. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the pickup there. 2nd and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up 2nd and goal. At the Jaguars.
On 2nd and goal, they'll give it to him again. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. And now this defense trying to use the clock to their advantage. They'll take the timeout here with 2:08 left. And then they'll have another stop coming up at the 2-minute warning. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal.
47 is the mic. 47 is the mic. You must get tired of seeing me. 47 mic. 47 mic. Mic 47. He's tired of me.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Big play coming here. It's 3rd and goal. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Corey Davis, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Makes the score Jets 24. Jaguars.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Well, conventional football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4. And right now, defensively, you love that, don't you? I mean, you'll give them that play.
And they'll take it every single time. This is almost like nickeling and diming it downfield, and too much time's going to run off the clock.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
The Jaguars send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. It's taken to the 26. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Jets will take over 1st and 10. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And checking the timeouts, they do have 2 defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. Eluding the pressure right. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Turns out to be a great idea to tuck that one. Good for 24 yards. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, in all likelihood, this ball game's still over. I mean, even with the interception, two-score game, they need a miracle.
Curious decision to even throw the ball in that situation, but maybe they saw a stacked line of scrimmage and said, hey, it's better to try and throw it than to try and run against it. In any event, I think you're exactly right. Now, the other team can pad their stats, but I don't think they're going to win.
Yeah, but still, don't change the channel just yet. They run the counter now on first down. And some room to maneuver. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
Well, definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. They'll set up a throw, escaping the pressure right. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Marcus May with a pick, and his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
The Jets take over first and 10 at their own 47-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They're in a good spot. Two-possession game, barely, but a two-possession game here late. Now they just have to put this game on ice.
Let's face it, right now, they're talking about ball security, taking care of it, not allowing anything crazy to happen, because we've seen nutty things happen down the stretch, but they also have the security of the scoreboard. With that type of a lead, even if something goes haywire, they're still in good shape.
Here to his running back. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now a handoff looking right. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's a gain of 8 there, and that should be enough to seal the victory. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. So it's a victory here for the New York Jets, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the Jets, they continue to make their case for the playoffs as they move to 9-3. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Buffalo Bills next week. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, the playoffs look to be out of reach now as they drop to 4-8. And they'll be at home next week for a date.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend their hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. Sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you when you feel the cold. But I can't go, no I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check. Not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step. Your chain, name, highlight your respect. Give them more than what I can.
down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news. Okay. I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot. Okay. I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more. Okay. Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of bait. You can't negotiate with Dre. You gon' have to pay. But wait, jugging on the main stage, the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay. Meditate, hydrate. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't wanna seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle, pockets LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I wanna see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that, it's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line. No lie. Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb. Came out of my mama with some running tennis shoes. Faster than the speed and bullet.
Nah, 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 nah. It's cool, it's cool. Don't play with it, play.
Say it, so what you gon' do?
Well, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock them down to their cold cases. Marathon run, I'ma slow pace it. They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place. And if we pulling up with the whole squad, are you ready? Done told y'all that you better be.